So there's this kind of thought process in the gun industry, right, where the idea of modifying or heavily modifying your firearm could actually get you in more trouble if you have to use it in self-defense, with respect to it making it seem as if you wanted to kill someone, like you had this lustful desire to kill someone, therefore you wanted to make your gun as efficient as possible so that you could be the most efficient killer that you could possibly be.
Today's question is from Brandon. It says, do you open yourself up to issues by carrying a weapon with an aftermarket trigger or modified trigger? Interesting question. Get it a lot. Michael, what's your take on that?
I don't think so. You know, you could try to have a prosecutor that would make hay, this guy replaced the trigger, but there's nothing inherently that about replacing a trigger that makes the gun more dangerous.
Yeah, there's a lot of opinions out there. A lot of experts that'll say, you know, you are opening yourself up to evidence that could come in, that you were looking to kill somebody, you were trying to be a more violent person. Never seen that in my career. I've actually got a lot of friends that are prosecutors, and I've asked them about that, and they said it doesn't
happen. Again, say that we do end up in trial, and it is, it does come in that you have this heavily modified handgun that is a crazy killing machine. It is our job to basically bring in experts and show the jury that this is actually what the lawful gun owner can possess, number one, and number two, that perhaps it helps in making the firearm actually more
are
safe.
Are people mixing the fun guy stuff that they're going to have at the range, guns that are different colors, guns that have zombie killer on them or have different type of skulls, any aggressive type of markings on the weapons, from a concealed carry standpoint, leave that stuff in your fun guy range bag. I want to look at something as a defense attorney who travels around the country defending cases. I want a concealed carry setup that is very closely mimics a law enforcement setup. It doesn't have anything aggressive or indicate that you were seeking out some type of a concealed incident, a use of force.
I think there's
incident.
Some credit that needs to be lended to that sort of mindset, because I mean, everything you do is going to be dissected in front of that jury. So if we get a prosecutor who says, "Oh my gosh, there's a 3-pound, you know, trigger guard on this," you know, this is Murder Man Jones, and they are ready just to murder anybody that comes into their house, and they're going to like it. Well, it's our job as defense attorneys to basically take that sort of evidence that could potentially be seen
that's
as
what
harmful.
I look to see, and there's a lot of products out there, holsters, of course, you know, magazine holders that are different colors and have bells and whistles and zombie stuff written on them. I don't want to see that. I want to see something that is very simple, very basic, safe. That gives a glimpse into your actual mindset of defending yourself, not looking for some type of a use of force incident.
And if it does happen, as long as you don't have a gun or you're etching in it how many people you killed every time you killed them, or you have a crazy, you know, gun that's colored in blood red or something bizarre, you know, I don't think it's really a negative issue. You know, so having a modified trigger to make you more of an expert marksman to defend your life, I don't think is necessarily a horrible thing.
You know, if a trigger's too light, it leads to accidental discharges, or under conditions of stress, you'll launch a round downrange when you don't intend to. From a lawyer CCW point of view, what's your thought press on trigger pull weights in terms of how light should the trigger be on your carry gun?
It's a great question. I think you should have your everyday carry gun that you're going to carry pursuant to your concealed weapon permit should have a trigger pull that's consistent with what your local law enforcement agency is going to have, because that's already deemed reasonable. It's already been vetted by, you know, range officers. It's typically going to be something that came directly from the manufacturer. That's always the best way to go.